Let me tell you the story of a dream. The dream of using one cable for everything. No more separate HDMI, audio, USB, Ethernet, power, or anything really. Just one port with one cable that can do everything you could ever want. And it would be a small port, so small that laptops would be thinner. We can put it on smartphones too. That sounds great! What should we use? Well, USB did a great job of standardizing a lot of stuff. Let's make a USB port that's strong, reversible, and can do the job of all the other ports. That's perfect, right? Turns out, not really. Years after this decision, we're in compatibility hell. Now, we have USB-C ports everywhere that look the same, but do not do the same thing. Find the nearest thing with a USB-C port near you, probably on a laptop. It's this round thing. Can you tell at a glance what it does? Data? Sound? Power? If you think it does all of the above, you're probably wrong. If you're lucky, the manufacturer has marked it with a tiny symbol that signifies what it does. Just look up what that symbol means and what are the limits of that standard depending on what version it is. Okay, now you know what the port does. All you need to do is plug in a USB-C cable and it'll work, right? Nope. Now you have to match the cable. Not all USB-C cables do the same thing. Some cables are good for data, some are good for sound, some are good for power. Most do multiple things. How can you tell? I hope you kept the packaging they came in, because there's no way to tell just by looking at the cable. Really. And the worst thing? If you buy a high-end computer, that's all you get. Get a nice new sleek laptop that only has one or two USB-C ports. One is used to charge the laptop, so you're left with only one to fiddle with to try to connect a mouse, projector, a USB stick, or whatever you need. This is not just frustrating, it's costing money. People can't use their devices, so they miss opportunities. But it's okay, we can use dongles, right? That's the new, weirdly suggestive name for adapters. Companies say they'll carry us to the bright one-port future. First of all, if I buy a sleek high-end device, I don't want to carry a bag of dongles with me. That's the opposite of sleek and high-end. Not to mention, they can be super expensive. Secondly, dongles don't always work. It's the same problem as with matching ports and cables. And even if you do match the ports, the dongle might be simply incompatible with that particular device and not work at all. I'm not joking. This problem is only compounded on smartphones. Ever since Apple removed the headphone jack, other smartphone manufacturers have been racing to eliminate it too, leaving us with only a USB-C port. Just use a dongle, they say. But be careful, because it might not work. There's a great video floating around that illustrates this perfectly. I'll link it below. Let's say you get over this. You have a dongle that you know works. You carry your prized dongle everywhere you go, and you're careful not to lose it. Is that enough? No. To misquote a Verge article, there's still no easy way to simultaneously charge and listen without headphone jacks. Before you say it, that's not a niche use case. Everyone who travels needs to do that. You're on the plane and you have a power bank plus your headphones plugged in. Traveling is not a niche. But every double dongle out there drops quality, hisses, pops, beeps, limits charging, or flat out doesn't work. So why not forget about cables? Let's all just use Bluetooth. That works, right? First of all, a good pair of Bluetooth headphones costs hundreds. Secondly, let's face the fact that Bluetooth audio is still a mess in 2018. If I have headphones and I want to switch from listening to my phone to my computer, with my wired headphones I just unplug my phone and jack into the computer in 1 second. With Bluetooth I have to unpair from my phone and pair again with my computer, a process which can take a long time if you're unlucky and Bluetooth decides to spaz out. You could use multi-pairing, but support is hit or miss. Your phone or laptop might not support it. Even high-end headphones don't have it. Let's take a concrete example. You have $350 Bose headphones with multi-pairing that sound worse than $20 Xiaomi earbuds. You could opt for the $350 Sony equivalents, which sound great, but they don't have multi-pairing. Why are we forced to make these ludicrous, expensive choices? I want to listen to my music on my phone and then jump to the conference call on my laptop. This is basic stuff that we used to be able to do seamlessly. Not to mention, Bluetooth means another thing you have to keep charged all the time. Don't get me wrong, I love the fact that USB-C is reversible and much sturdier than micro USB before it. But technology is supposed to make our lives easier. Is this fixable? It has to be. I would propose to start with color-coding cables and USB ports. Just put a nice ring of color on the end of the connector so we know what kind of cable we have to match it to. For laptops, putting all the missing ports on the bundled charger is a good start. That way you don't have a stupid dongle to worry about. And if you forget your own, compatibility should be assured so you can use someone else's charger and ports. And for smartphones, give us back the headphone jack, or at least put two USB-C ports on your phone. I would say fix the dongle compatibility situation, but they're only supposed to be a solution for the transition period. The transition is already taking too long. I don't believe it's anyone's fault in particular. We just got into this mess through a series of compromises and bad calls. Hopefully, someone will listen. Because I believe technology can build a utopia, but we have to design it carefully.